Hello, my name is Christian Finelli. I'm a senior solution architect at AWS. Today we're here exploring how Ericsson are leveraging agentic AI technology from AWS to accelerate CSP journey to autonomous networks. Team 4 have defined 5 levels of automation. Most of the CSP are at level 1, 2, or 3. To break into level 4 and 5 of automation, it requires a new paradigm. The reason is automation here is driven by intent. Intent is business intent in this case, which comes from multiple stakeholders. This intent might be conflicting, might be in contrast. So agentic AI is the key enabler here to allow the decomposition, the orchestration, and the reconciliation of business intent, translation into service intents and resource intents. I'll leave the stage to Ericsson to explore how agentic AI technologies are used by Ericsson across the stack, business and resource intent.
Hi, I'm Mohit Bhargava from Ericsson, and I will be taking you through the business intent management use case. So let's look at an example where we have a CSP called Fuon. Fuon has two business intent. That is, it wants to provide X percent margin on its surveillance product, and it also wants to give a high quality of experience to its VIP customers for the surveillance product. We will also be looking at the customer journey of two customers, a VIP customer who wants to purchase a surveillance product and a premium customer who wants to purchase an HT surveillance product. So we'll look at the journey where both the customer intent, this is to get a 4K surveillance or HD surveillance product, and the CSP's intent to have higher margins and have a better quality of experience for VIP customer is solved. So let's go into the case of Fuon, where there's a product manager who looks at the sales of the surveillance product. He sees there is a decline in the sales, and he talks to an AI assistant to update the business objectives. So he says, I want to add 2 business intent. So the product manager says that the first intent is, I want to have W percent margin on my product sales. And the AI assistant then asks the further question, what different segments you have in mind for this particular intent? So he says all segments. He then further asks which particular products he wants to use for this intent. So surveillance products is the one he wants to use. So what happens at the back end is that CSP sends this intent to intent handler, which captures the intent, and then it is translated into technical requirements through the TMF 921 API. Now, all the intents are registered in this business intent management system. The CSP can add, the program manager can add another intent. So would you like to add another intent? Yes, I want to provide a very high quality to my VIP customers. So again, the intent get captured by intent handler, and then it is through TMF 921 API, it is translated and it get registered in this business intent management system. Now, when we have multiple intents, there could be conflict between the intents. So the CSP wants to prioritize the intent. So the AI assistant asks, do you want to prioritize one of the intents? So yes, the program manager answers that I want to have the quality of experience as the priority intent over the margin intent. So in this case, the priority is also registered. So all the rules, everything is registered in this business intent management system. So once all the intents are registered, the product manager can look at the products that is available for the surveillance service. So he can talk to the AI assistant and ask for these products. So Surveillance Ultra, Surveillance Premium, and Surveillance Super are the 3 products which are available to the customers. Now here we finished the registration of the intent. So these 2 intents have been registered. Now let us look at the journey of a customer, a VIP customer who wants to purchase a 4K surveillance product, and how these intents come into the play, and how an intelligent sales is made where both the customer and CSP intents are satisfied. So let's go to a journey of a VIP customer. This customer goes on the customer portal and he chats with the intelligent assistant that I want a 4K surveillance service with very high availability. The customer intent goes to the intent handler. It is captured there. Then it gets translated into the technical requirement using the 921 API, and then a guided selling agents come into the play. Now this guided selling agents talks to the Ericsson core commerce system to get the right products for this particular customer based on this customer intent. The business intent management function that then ensures that only those products are recommended which also satisfies the CSP intent of margin and quality. So we see Surveillance Ultra and Surveillance Premium are the two products that satisfies the intent of customer, as well as CSP Ultra is a recommended product. The customer goes with the recommendation of the CSP, and this product is allocated to the customer through this process here. So shopping cart, product order management, and service ordering, and it goes to the service layer next. So this is how we see that intelligent sales is made, where a customer intent is also satisfied. He got the product he want, and where CSP intent of margin and a very high quality is also satisfied. Now let's look into an example where there is no product that is satisfying the customer and the CSP intent. So let's say there's a premium customer, and she wants a HD surveillance service with 99.99% availability. Again, she goes to the customer portal, she chats with the AI chatbot, she provides her requirement and the intent. This intent goes to intent handler, it is captured there, it then converts into the technical requirement, and it is where the guided selling agent comes into the play again. It tries to search for a product that satisfies all the intents, but there is no product which satisfies all the intent. So in this case, the product manager will get a message that there is no product that satisfies the margin intent, let's say, in this case. So do you want to create a new product for this particular customer? The product manager agrees, and then we again go back into the process. Now a third agent will come in, where the product configuration assistant agent, which will actually help to create a new product offer and configure it. So this product configuration assistant agent again talks to the core commerce system. It creates the new product offer and configures it in the catalog. And this new product called Surveillance Superior HD is created. Now this product is offered to the customer, and the customer agrees to buy this product. So then again, the sales cycle would be completed with the product, the shopping cart, the product ordering, and the service ordering, and it goes to the next layer. So again, we saw that when there was no product, a new product was created that satisfies all the intent, and then again, an intelligent sales was made. For this, we are using a multi-agentic architecture, where you saw multiple agents like a guided selling agent, a product configuration agent, the business intent management agent, all coming together to achieve this objective of intelligent sale. And this is built over the Amazon Bedrock platform.
We've just seen as how Amazon Bedrock is the key enabler for Ericsson to achieve their agentic AI architecture. There are four key traits that are important here for Amazon Bedrock. First and foremost is AI enterprise-grade security with full data control and full data protection. Second is the large selection of LLM for multi-step reasoning and orchestration of multi-agents. Third is the capability for Amazon Bedrock to scale and to meet performance of tier one CSP globally. And fourth is the capability of Amazon Bedrock to allow fast experimentation to reduce the time from idea to market.